Somebody once told me the world is gonna roll me.
Summer.
Ain't the sharpest tool in the shed.
One more day.
She was looking kind of dumb with her finger and her thumb in the shape of an L on her forehead. Well, the years start coming and they don't stop coming. Fed to the rules and I hit the ground running. Didn't make sense.
It's 8:15. Shit, I'm gonna be late.
So much to do, so much to see. So what's wrong with taking the back streets? You'll never know if you don't go. You'll never shine if you don't glow. Hey now, you're an all-star. Get your game on, go play. Hey now, you're a rock star. Get the show on, get paid.
And all that from is
I'm used to you being late. Besides, it's the last day of school. Be happy.
Thank God.
Hi, YouTube. So today's the last day of school. I'm super excited. I'm in Allison's car right now, and we'll see you after school.
So, we're walking home from school to Darcy's house because my stupid brother took the car. But it's finally summer break.
Anyways, that's all for today. Bye, YouTube.
Bye.
Shane uploaded a conspiracy video. Wanna watch it?
Yes, obviously.
Hey, what's up, you guys? Yes, today we're gonna be talking about another haunted location. So this forest was originally an estate owned by a man named Charles H. Cobb. When he died in the 1950s, it started to decay. Then as the house and the land decayed, it turned into like a hub of criminal activity. It is also said to be haunted by the ghost of Cobb. And he's really, really pissed because they turned his land into a place of evil. So that's the most haunted forest in the world. Now, obviously, I'm not close to that forest, and plus, I wouldn't go there anyways. But there is a-
He's talking about the Sherwood Forest. That's near us.
Ooh, we should take our camera and check it out.
Yeah, we'll totally get some great footage.
I'll edit what we filmed today.
Okay. Actually, I have to go, but while you edit, I can research about the forest at home.
Okay.
Can I take the camera with me?
Sure.
Okay, thanks, and I'll see you later.
Bye.
Bye. Good morning, guys. First day of summer, thank God. I'm gonna go pick up Darcy and then we're gonna explore a haunted forest.
Good morning.
Please tell me we're getting coffee.
I'm one step ahead.
Ah. We made it to Sherwood Forest.
Things are looking pretty creepy, like Shane said.
I wonder if we'll see the ghost of Cobbs like Shane said.
Ooh, spooky.
Oh, what's that? Oh, cool.
What's this? Darcy, come here.
Whoa, what's that?
They're letters. Many people think that my
family is well behaved. But if family loyalty means anything to you, you probably aren't a member of the Sherwoods. Indeed, in the Sherwoods case, ink is thicker than blood. My father, Charles H. Cobbs, 12-year-old son, David Jean Sherwood, was kidnapped while we were vacationing in Rome. A ransom of $17 million was ordered via mail. My miserable father refused to pay it. He claimed that his son was merely trying to mooch off of him. He said that if his son had been kidnapped, and he gave in to the kidnapper's demands, it would be putting his three other kids at risk. The kidnappers loped off one of my brother's ears and sent a letter along with the ear, demanding a reduced $3.2 million. In the letter, they threatened to send Davis Sherwood back to his family in little bits and pieces if my father didn't pay up. My father still had a hard time protecting his own flesh and blood over his own interests. Accumulation, that is. Eventually, he agreed to pay the kidnappers $2.2 million, the smallest tax deductible amount allowed by law. My traumatized brother couldn't cope with his dismembering adventure in the Eternal City. After overdosing on Valium, methadone, and alcohol, he suffered a massive stroke that killed him.
Hey, wasn't Nick into this kind of stuff?
Nick?
To the three of us.
Together forever.
What would I do without you guys?
I don't know. He was into all kind of nerdy things. Let's bring these with us.
Wow, these look really old.
I wonder who they're from. I think they're journal entries. Look at this one.
John, my beloved brother, fancied kites so much that a storm couldn't stop him. I knew I should have told him to come inside, but seeing that smile on his face, I just let him be. I went back up to my study, while leaving him unattended to play. My parents were not there because they had other businesses to attend to. John wandered off into the forest, on the estate property. I was unaware of this as I was reading.
His kite must have gotten stuck up in the branches of a tree.
John was a determined young boy, so he climbed up the tree to retrieve the kite by himself, unaware that thunder could shake the tree out of its place. After hours of no return, I went in search of John.
John! 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 John!
Finding his limbs crushed under the tree, I cried for hours holding his lifeless hand, until one of the maids found me.
At the bottom of this one, it says her name's Elizabeth Sherwood.
Do you think they're all from her?
They must be. They're all talking about the same people.
Sherwood, why does that last name sound so familiar?
The fourth Piran was called Sherwood Forest.
Oh yeah, I remember you reading that letter about her father, Charles Cobb. Wait, why is his last name different then?
The kids must have taken the mom's last name, I guess?
Actually, I think I remember Nick talking about the Sherwood family.
Never mind Nick, look at this one. She's talking about hidden money.
I am fearful that my mother and father know about these letters. They are not happy with me trying to expose our secrets. Nobody knows what's going on behind the Sherwoods family business. It is filled with illegal firearms and drugs from the black market. I think that they want to silence me, for good. So this will be my last entry, as I am no longer safe here. I leave my share to the family fortune, to whomever is reading this. A total value of $9 million.
Do you know what we could buy with that kind of money? We could get all new camera equipment, you could get a car, we could fly to the Bahamas.
We can pay for college?
Yeah, that too. Only one problem. She explained where it was hidden in a riddle. We suck at riddles.
We know someone who's good at riddles.
Oh God, no, please.
Nick!
I still don't think this is a good idea.
Why?
We haven't talked to him in like a year. How do we even know he still lives here?
He's right there.
Where's he going?
What are you doing here?
We need your help.
Help? Why would I help you?
Come on, this is right up your alley.
How would you know what I like? You left me for your stupid videos!
Okay, stop being petty and just let us explain.
I'm listening.
So we watched Shane's new video about the Sherwood Forest, and we decided to go explore it since we live near it, but then we found this old box with a bunch of old letters in it, and we think they're from Elizabeth Sherwood.
Shh! We can't talk about this here.
Why?
I'll be right back. My family's home. Let's go to your house.
So does that mean you're gonna help us?
Yes, but we have to get to her house first. Waldo, I found these in the back corner of the Northbury Library. I started looking into the Sherwoods, but as soon as I did, this weird guy in a black hood started following me. That creeped me out, so I stopped researching.
Okay, well, what is all this?
Apparently this girl, who wrote the letters you found, is Charles Cobb's daughter. But one day she was mysteriously murdered and no one knows why. People think it's because she knew where the family fortune was, and they've been after the letters ever since.
I'll get the letters.
Letters. I can't believe you got a hold of these.
It says right here that she hid $9 million, but the location's in a riddle.
A riddle? I'm really good at riddles.
We know. It's right up there.
It is put in the below the home of Brown where lies the sleeping soul, a hint of riches new and old, hidden below for those to seek, and the answers I already know. I have tried to speak, but now I am weak, and I have left it under the sideways tree. But beware of those impure, for blood will be shed and pages will be torn.
See, it makes no sense.
What you're talking about makes total sense.
What does it mean then?
Well, it talks about a tree, so it's back in the forest, and under the home of Brown means dirt, so it's buried.
Okay, but what does the part of there lies the sleeping soul mean?
Well, did someone die?
Actually. In one of her letters, she talks about her brother dying because a tree crushed him.
So you mean she buried the treasure underneath the tree that crushed her brother? That's dark.
Oh.
Well, now that we know where it's hidden, let's go.
No! Do you not see the part about those impure and blood will be shed?
Yes, so?
Other people are going after this money. Bad people. That man in the hood who started following me, he's probably one of them.
That's just a coincidence. That part in the riddle is probably just there to scare us.
Come on, Nick. If you help us find the money, we'll split it evenly. $3 million each.
Fine, we'll go tomorrow.
You coming?
On second thought, I think I'm just gonna stay here and be the lookout, you know, just in case anyone catches us for trespassing.
Okay, whatever, scaredy cat. Don't die or anything.
Right.
Okay guys, so we just found out that the letters lead to treasure.
And now we're gonna go find it, so wish us luck.
No, frick. Allison, come on, pick up the phone. Come on. Darcy, you're always on your phone.
Hey, there's another fallen tree. Maybe that's it.
We've gotta film this.
This is it. It's all here. Oh my god. We found it.
Oh my god, we finally found it.
This is insane. Darcy, we're gonna be rich.
Nick's totally gonna freak out.
I know, he's going to go insane.
Come on, Darcy, Allison, someone.
I'm gonna call Nick. Darcy, you can help me bring this to the car. Darcy? No! No!
Come on. Allison, are you okay?
Nick! Nick, help me!
I'm gonna get some help, okay?
No,
okay?
No!
Okay.
No!
911, what is your emergency?
Lips when the wind blows, black tint on the windows. I can't see what the future holds, but I wanna know. I tiptoe on the dirt road to
hot through the dark.